And now it's time for Mad Interviews on the Mr. Bob Show. Greetings, everybody. I am Mr. Bob, and welcome to my interview show. Now, today I am going to do something special. We are going to see what my show will be like 3 years in the future. The only problem is, our scientists haven't worked out time travel yet, so you'll have to wait. Hello and welcome to Mad Interviews. I've taken over the interview show now because Mr. Bob has left, and today I'm supposed to be interviewing Ricky, but I'm not going to do it because I absolutely hate him. So Jason?
Yee?
The mic's all yours. Okay, well, here I am. It's me, Jason. And, this is my first time being the interviewer, and I guess I'll be interviewing Ricky. So, come in, Ricky. Walk into studio. Wank, 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 wank. Ah, there you are, Ricky. Now, I'm going to be interviewing you today. Whatever. Sit. Okay, firstly, I want to know why when you came in just now, why did you go wank, 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 wank? Answered Jason's question. Because I like to wank. Because I'm a teenager and wanking's good. It's a great teenage way to kill time. And I have to keep telling myself what I'm just about to do. Or I forget and don't do it because I don't got any brains because I'm a teenager. Okay, does that mean you were, you know, wanking? Yeah. Yeah, and I'm also high right now. I see, that means you're a wanker, Ricky. Yeah, I know. He's so high he doesn't even know I'm insulting him. What? Nothing. Anyway, Ricky, I want to interview you about what you do with your life, because we've all heard that you've become a typical teenager, and we all want to know what typical teenagers do. Well, you already know I'm a wanker. Yeah, we're getting tired of hearing that now. Let's talk about what school you go to.
Well, don't go to no school.
Oh, have you finished school then?
No, I just don't go. I'm 15, right? At least I think I am. I'm so high, I don't know what's going on. But I don't go to school. It's for losers. School's for pricks like Clem.
And why did you say Clem is a prick?
'Cause he is.
He's not.
He is.
He's not.
He is.
He's not.
He is.
He is.
He's not.
He is.
He's not.
He is.
He's not.
He is.
Listen, Jason. If I say Clement's not a prick, it means it's not a prick, okay?
Okay, whatever. So why do you seem to be so depressed?
Because I am.
And why are you depressed then, Ricky?
Because I'm a teenager. Teenagers have to be depressed. It's part of the unwritten teenage law. So I make myself depressed by listening to all of today's club music.
But all the music they play in the clubs these days is just sad sawtooth wave chords and a pounding kick drum. It's hardly music.
Well, I call it music. It gets me depressed enough. I like playing it real loud at night and having parties all night long. Every night, just to keep people awake, because us teenagers love doing that. In fact, I wouldn't even care if I suddenly went blind and never saw anything again. Just as long as my ears work and I've got my music, things are cool.
But do you really want to be depressed?
Yeah. I have to be depressed. I need to be depressed. I'm happy when I'm depressed.
You're happy when you're depressed? That doesn't even make sense.
Would if you were me.
I guess. But anyway, Ricky, what else do you do?
Well, I smoke pot, weed, dope and other drugs. I kill people just for the fun of it. Steal things, and that's about it.
Do your friends do it as well?
Yeah, it's a teenage thing. We all do it. And we all love doing it, too. It's even a teenage law.
But Clement and Jane and Paul and Jameson, my sister and me, never do any of that stuff, and we're all teenagers now.
I was talking about my other teenage friends, the ones who actually decided to become typical teenagers. Do you want to see what I kill people with?
Okay. Oh, that's a nice knife, Ricky. Can I have a closer look at it?
Yeah, you're gonna get a real close-up of it. I'm gonna stab you with it.
Huh? Ah, you stabbed me!
My name is Mr. Bob, and I've decided to come back to the interview show. I'm swinging the microphone round and round and round. Ow! Sorry about that, everybody. I was just trying to lighten the mood because a sad thing has happened. Ricky has killed Jason, so Ricky is now in jail, and Jason is dead. I am interviewing Clement Saggers to see what he has to say about this.
Oh, yeah, it's a terrible thing, but I've got an idea. I might be able to save Jason.
But you're too late. He's already dead.
I know, but I went to a car boot sale once, and you can get some very weird stuff there. Anyway, I bought a couple of things from one of the stalls there. I got a time machine, and I also got an enlargement ray, and I'm going to use these to save Jason.
So, what exactly are you going to do?
I'm going to go back in time to just before Ricky kills Jason, and I'm going to make myself really big, and squash Ricky before he does anything.
Well, I wish you the best of luck, Clem.
Well, I'm off to save Jason now.
Yeah, you're gonna get a real close-up of it. I'm gonna stab you with it.
Huh?
Hey!
Oh, it's Clement. What do you want? I'm busy.
I'm here to stop you murdering Jason, Ricky.
Oh yeah? What you gonna do about it?
I'm gonna squash you. You're still smaller than me.
Oh, thank you, Clement. Thank you for saving me. He was about to kill me.
Hey, take it easy, Jason.
It was incredible, Mr. Bob. Clem saved me. He just suddenly appeared out of nowhere, and there he was, and he was so big he squashed Ricky like a bug.
That's right, everybody. And you saw it all here, only on the Mr. Bob Show. Well, that's about all the time we have this week on the Mr. Bob Show. So, from me, to everybody who has bothered to show up tonight, good night. And see you next time.